I'm a B pharmacist and MBA marketing. I'm also a clinical psychologist. Last 15 years, I've worked with various pharmaceutical companies as a marketing team, product management team. And today we are going to understand that the topic is understanding anxiety and depression disorders. So, from medical background point of view, we'll try to understand what are the symptoms of anxiety disorders, depression disorders, and we'll try to cover case studies as well. Okay, so just to begin with, many of the times we use this words anxiety, depression, that is very common words nowadays. But whether we are able to differentiate between a normal type of anxiety or pathological anxiety. Because if am I going to face exam, I'm going to feel anxious. If am I going to give some performance in front of a public, I'm going to feel anxious. But suppose if it is not a normal anxious, but if it is a pathological anxiousness or pathological anxiety, then there is a problem that may require a medication, that may require a therapy. So, able to understand between the normal anxiety concern and the pathological anxiety. Feeling anxious about how to finish large course within stipulated time. You may welcome this anxiety at least to a certain extent. It would help you learn quickly and to get good marks. Anxiety is indeed a common reaction to stress. Actually, it is helpful to us so that we can prepare ourselves better. If we have a little bit anxiousness, probably we will work for it.
It motivates you.
If that is that motivates you. Say in case of एक कबीर के दोहे में कहा गया है, भय से भक्ति करे सब, भय से पूजा है होए, भय पारस है जीव को निर्भय हो न कोई. That means nobody is going to be stress free or nobody is going to be free of भय. भय इज गोइंग टू बी अ पार्ट एंड पार्सल, बट भय कितना होना चाहिए विच विल हेल्प अस टू मोटिवेट एंड टू डू समथिंग गुड अबाउट इट और गो इन टू सम पैथोलॉजिकल कंडीशन. ओके, अनलेस यू हैव एंजाइटी अबाउट योर एग्जामिनेशन यू वुड नॉट स्टडी. सो यू नीड टू हैव दैट एंजाइटी. अनलेस द मदर हैज एंजाइटी ओवर द बेबीज हेल्थ, she might forget to take care of the infant. If she has so much of anxiety and that I should take care of my baby's health, nothing should happen to my baby. So in that worryness or that anxiousness, if she is not able to handle baby, then comes a pathological anxiety. I think that has been understood very well. Let's not take more examples on this. So, anxiety disorder is a group of disorders, each of which needs special attention and understanding. You know that in classifying disorders, we usually follow either the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual version 4. Okay, so this is medically it is known as DSM-IV, which is a 4th edition. So, DSM is nothing but Diagnostic Statistical Manual, and this manual helps across industry to understand how that disorder defined, what are the symptoms and what we are supposed to do it in terms of the treatment. So this is that manual work as the ideal one. Okay, so according to DSM, the primary types of anxiety disorders are panic disorders with or without agoraphobia. Agoraphobia means phobia with the public or with the places. Wherever the people are more or crowded, phobia is pertaining to that place or that public area or the crowded place. So that is with or without agoraphobia. Phobic disorders of the specific or social type. एक तो specific type का phobia है या it is social science. We will see in detail. These are just names. Generalized anxiety disorders, obsessive compulsive disorder, post traumatic stress disorders. So all these disorders comes under primary types of anxiety.
What is an obsessive compulsive
behavior? That we will see, okay, one by one. So, nature of anxiety and anxiety disorder. Anxiety disorder is a blanket term that covers a number of disorders, okay. And in this context, you must be aware that the difference between the fear and anxiety. Fear is a basic emotion of human beings. It is associated with the perception of real threatening situation and involves the fight or flight response activated by the sympathetic nervous system. And if thug attacks you in the street, you would feel intense fear. So then you would either run for the dear life or hit him back. So this fear involves cognition of the threatening object and subjective cognition of the being of the danger. Physiological components like increased heart rates and behavioral components like running or hitting. So what is this talking about, nature of anxiety? So whenever you come across some threatening situation, your body responds. Your body responds in terms of what? We have nervous systems. Autonomic nervous systems. There are two parts of autonomic nervous system. One is sympathetic and one is parasympathetic. Sympathetic nervous systems, that act, the moment it activates, there are different behavioral things or changes happens in body. What is that? Heart rate will increase. Okay, you will feel there is an increased level of glucose, because glucose is required for blood supply, oxygen supply, nutrient supply, so that in that particular situation, that person can, is a situation of emergency. The person will flight or fight with that. So immediately that sympathetic nervous system will get activated. Either he will run away or he will fight back. So it is a matter of something which is emergency has come. Okay. Physiological changes and some kind of a behavioral reactions, but unlike fear, it has no immediate threat. In fear, there is an immediate threat, but like in case of anxiety, there could not be an immediate threat. That could be a perceived threat. If you cannot go out of your home because you are always apprehending an attack from a thug, it is nothing but an anxiety. घर के बाहर ही नहीं निकलोगे क्योंकि कोई आके चोर मुझे लूट लेगा. So that is anxiety. You are projecting the threatening situation in future and reacting to it as if it is imminent. It is, whether it is going to happen or not, you do not know. But that is, you are projecting कि ऐसा बाहर जाने से ऐसा होने ही वाला है. And then you react to it, to the sensation, and you get that anxiety. So what are the symptoms? Person sweats, almost faints, complaints of breathing, because breathlessness that patient feels or person feels, people think as if he is going to get or he got a heart attack, that kind of a feeling people think. But after some time gradually recovers and normal, and it is an episode of intense fear people later on come to know. Symptoms develop abruptly, usually reach its peak within 10 to 15 minutes. During such attack, the victim becomes completely overpowered by the symptoms, and many of which are physiological in nature. Actually, nothing has happened, but those are just a physiological response. Now, coming to panic attacks, are characterized by their expectedness. DSM mandates that a person would be diagnosed as a suffering from a panic disorder if she had anxiety disorder, if she had panic and phobias, generalized anxiety disorder, any other mental mind disorders, experience recurrent unexpected attacks, is persistently concerned with having another attack, and this condition must go on for at least 1 month. That means the person who is in panic attack, there are two things. First, the first exposure of getting a panic attack, and subsequent कि वैसा पैनिक अटैक मुझे फ्यूचर में आएगा और अभी आएगा, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू टेंड टू गेट पैनिक. सो देयर कुड बी अ टू, लाइक वन इज द फर्स्ट एक्सपोजर टू द पैनिक अटैक, एंड सेकंड इट कुड बी द सब्सिक्वेंट, वो आता रहेगा, वो आ गया तो यू नो, सो अगेन दैट पर्सन, ही और शी इज गोइंग टू गेट दैट पैनिक अटैक. person must have the four symptoms about falling. When we can say the panic attack, यहाँ पे जो भी listed down किए हैं उसमें से at least four symptoms अगर नजर आते हैं तो you can say those are that person is suffering from panic attack. That is palpitation, sweating, trembling or shaking, sensation of shortness of breath or begin smothered, feeling of choking, chest pain or discomfort, okay, feeling dizzy, lightheadedness, derealization or depersonalization, okay, fear of losing control or going crazy, fear of dying, okay, so chill or hot flushes, any of this happens. Now I remember one thing, 10 years ago my colleague, she was supposed to speak in front of a camera about one particular topic, and that was of exposure, first time exposure speaking in front of a camera. Okay, she was like, you know, getting like, you know, shaky feeling, nervous and all, but that is common thing. But in this panic, the moment that camera was on, literally she fainted and she collapsed. So that is nothing but panic attack, feeling of all the symptoms, sweating and all, and after some time she was okay and normal. Okay, so now probably you must have got the idea about the panic attack. So these are the different the reactions are usually those associated with the activation of sympathetic nervous system, which we have already spoken. In case of the activation of sympathetic nervous system, heart rate increases, increases in the glucose, feel like to run away, and body gets the energy and nutrients so that it can function it properly, because that's an emergency situation. So we have discussed about this autonomic nervous system, sympathetic nervous, threat gets perceived, feel like to run away, heart rate increases, liver release glucose, bronchioles are dilated because more oxygen should come into the body, inside the body, pupils are dilated because your threat is there, and it is because people to understand that that person is got surprised, so pupil get dilated. Adrenal gland secrete epinephrine and norepinephrine. Now these are the hormones or gets activated at this particular time. Now this adrenal gland is situated on the kidney. In emergency situation, these two hormones which reinforce the sympathetic nervous system ka, like, you know, action, get reinforced further. Digestion is inhibited because the entire energy is required to get the energy of to all parts of the body, and bladder is relaxed. So these are all the activation of the sympathetic nervous system. Parasympathetic sympathetic nervous system, once that episode is through or over, then body needs to relax and recuperate from that panic episodic attack. So uske liye kya ho jata hai, now your parasympathetic nervous system gets activated, and during this period what happens, your heart rate get decreases because you need to now calm down. Liver produces bile, bronchioles are constricted, now you no more require that kind of that much of the air to be, like, you know, pulled in. Pupils constrict, normal ho jata hai. Adrenal glands stop secreting those hormones, digestion is stimulated, and bladder contracts. So we have, in the beginning itself, we have understood agoraphobia, meaning that is the Greek word agora, which means public places or assembly of people. Panic attacks can be with or without agoraphobia. So typically panic attacks with agoraphobia seem to be precipitated by attending a cinema hall, shopping mall, queue for tickets, tunnels, trains and aircraft and so on, where a large number of people congregate, and escape in case of a panic attack may be difficult. So person feels that, like, you know, place is so crowded, okay, and if at all I get a panic at all, or if I feel a breathlessness, like, you know, escaping out of that place would be very difficult, and with that sensation also, with that feeling also, probably he gets more panicky and anxious. I will see a case study, okay, where name has been changed so that we can keep a confidentiality of the patient. A case study of a panic attack. Maya is a young lady studying at the university. She comes from a middle class family living in a suburban place. Maya is somewhat introvert, apparently cool and rational, and determined to finish her education. She has to travel every day by metro rail to come to the university. One day while waiting for the train, she had some kind of a physical discomfort. While standing at the platform itself, she started getting some discomfort, but she ignored that. However, she ignored it and boarded the train. The train was moderately crowded and she did not get a seat. She stood in front of the seat reserved for the ladies. A few minutes later, she felt choked and nauseated, starting sweating profusely, and her discomfort was so strong that she asked the elderly lady sitting in front of her for help. This lady immediately offered her a seat and asked her what her problem was. By that time, Maya was trembling and had started crying. "I'm going to die," she cried. Other passengers came forwarded to help and gave her water to drink. And at the next station, they took Maya out of the train and contacted the authority. Maya was taken to hospital and her father was informed. By the time her father arrived, Maya had been feeling much better. The doctors had found a rapid pulse rate but did not get anything indicating cardiac problem. Okay. Maya had retrospectively reported extreme fear of being choked to death, especially as she was in underground train and could not jump out and run for the sunlight up on the streets. So this is a episodic attack, but the moment you come out of that, you feel better. Many of the time, we also find cases where people have a fear of flying in the flight. So before that itself, they start panicky and many of the while flying also I have seen people where people are like doing like this or like trying to divert their mind, eating, popping something. Yes. So that is nothing but they come under the panic attack of anxiety. Now coming to phobia. Okay, phobia is also a part of primary type of anxiety. That's what we have said in the beginning. The word phobia derives from the name of the Greek god Phobos, who used to frighten his enemies. So that's the way the phobia came into the picture. A phobia is an intense and irrational fear of some object, living being or situation. Irrational fear. And it is intense fear. Do you get notably disturbed if cockroach flies around and falls on your body? The size of cockroach is small, but some people react as if
even rat also is very small.
So of course nobody would love to touch a cockroach, but some people get completely panicky at that thought of touching it. Screaming, shouting, running out of probably you must have seen around many of such cases where people give reactions, some kind of a reaction they show. Depending upon how severe it is, this may be a phobic reaction. One must have to say a phobic. Okay, how we can say you have a phobia problem? How we can diagnose that? As per the DSM, if there are certain criteria, one must have persistent and disproportionate fear of some specific object or social situation or crowded place that actually carries little danger. Exposure to the phobic stimulus almost invariably produces intense anxiety response. The patient usually knows that the fear is unreasonable, but she has no control on the reaction. That means person knows very well, by just falling a cockroach on my body, I am not going to die. But despite of that, that person gives unreasonable reaction towards that cockroach or lizard or rat. So that time one can say that person is suffering from phobia. So phobias are three types: specific phobia, Second one is social phobia and third is agoraphobia. The name says agoraphobia, it is related with crowded situation, crowded places. Specific phobia, that means you have a fear, intense fear for specific object or specific stimulus. And what are those? Some typical examples are fear of closed space, pura room band hai, dark hai. So some people get phobia. Fear of heights, fear of blood dekha to like, you know, people can't stand it, they will faint it and they will collapse. Fear of snake. किसी को तो snake ऐसा नाम भी बोला तो भी like they will get a phobia. Fear of spider, fear of fire, fear of like, you know, phobias or phonophobia, sound.
Yes.
कुछ sound का भी रहेगा तो भी they get scared, you know. So if at all if somebody is watching horror movies, so many of the times the person is like, you know, getting scared. First and foremost, what is he going to do it? First he will close his ear so that horror sound he will not listen.
Mobile vans also, that sound is very.
Huh?
Mobile van.
So it is animal, natural, blood, situation type. Okay. So we'll coming to directly to case study of a specific phobia. Okay. Here, a Kalu whose age is 24 by now, from a lower class family of fishermen. They earn livelihood by fishing in shallow backwaters or in streaming from big rivers. He had studied up to class 4 at local school and then left due to a poverty. And his child, he used to accompany his father to the backwaters, especially where they cultivated prawns. So he's from that, like, you know, from the poor family, and they were into the fishing thing. But during childhood, he had heard many stories that, like, where they cultivate their prawns and all, their crocodile used to come and they used to kill people. That kind of a story he heard, okay, at the time of a childhood. But he never ever seen that such thing is happening. He heard it in form of the stories. But as he grew up, he got caught with that particular thought. He started feeling as if I go deep in the water up to the knee level, some crocodile will come and he will eat me. If he is to see the shadow or like something like that, if some movement also in water, he is to get that fear. Eventually, what happened? He was reluctant to go inside the water and he was reluctant to do work. Now he was ultimately remained what? Like, you know, he stopped working. However, he had two more siblings, but now he is sitting at home and not doing anything. So he got that phobia. Okay. Now coming to a generalized anxiety disorder. It is also commonly known as GAD. Generalized anxiety disorder. Now you must have come across some person around who are known as nervous and shaky in general. They are nervous and shaky in general. You can come to know ki kuch galat hai, something is wrong. They are very hyper, they are very, like, you know, react to every stimulus. That's what you can make out from their behavior. They seem to be very anxious over every single step in life. Like, what are their thoughts behind this anxiousness? Would I be able to go to office in time? Is my dress suitable for my job? Am I capable of what am I supposed to do? Will the boss be angry over me? Would my children come back from school safely? What my wife forgets to put off the gas cylinder and have a terrible accident? Is it possible that I am robbed of my belongings on my way back home? So some or the other, they keep on like thinking ki abhi aisa ho jayega, abhi aisa ho jayega, abhi aisa ho jayega. No? If you try to console that person on one particular issue, wo chhod ke dusra pakad lenge. And they will erupt with new problem. And they are in that loop only. तो इस तरह से वो बढ़ता ही जाता है. वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मैनेज दैट काइंड ऑफ अ पेशेंट. people. Recently, I was I've been to Sion Hospital. Okay, so where I seen one patient where she just came in. Okay, 50 plus old lady, 50 plus old lady. She didn't even ask, "Ajao," nothing. She just like you know came inside, grabbed the chair, and she started like telling everything. You know, she was a follow-up patient, so doctor also knew. But with that anxiety, she entered in and she started. "Ki aaj maza asa thala, maja vadlani asa kela." She's unmarried and she was staying with the father and mother. आणि माझा भाऊ असं मला म्हणाला आणि मला असं जायचं होतं आणि मला तर काही कळत नाही. आणि मग मी गेले मोबाईलवाल्याकडे, मोबाईलवाल्याने मला मदत केली. ते झालं ना झालं, माझा दिवसभराचा कार्यक्रम हा असा असतो, थोडंसं डोक्याला ताप होतो आणि मी असं उठते, मग मी असं करते, मग असं करते. पण मग आता मला मोबाईलचा आवाज सहन होत नाही आहे, मला गाणी ऐकायला आवडतात. शी स्टार्टेड ग्रम्बलिंग फ्रॉम 1 पॉइंट टू अनदर 1 पॉइंट अँड आय वॉज लाईक Now she will allow doctor to say something. Now she will allow doctor to say something. But no, doctor was trying to open her mouth. Next problem was ready. Yeah, next problem was ready, and she was the only one who was to give the solution also. Khud hi solution dikha di thi, fir khud hi problem mila di thi, you know. So I've seen that, and she also had a OCD. You'll see that OCD, you know. So. This is the kind of a generalized anxiety disorder. Be patient, and very difficult to handle such people. So because of that, what happens is like, you know, in some such persons, the anxiety becomes so severe that their everyday functioning may be impaired. You know, in some persons, there is an unnatural concern for doing certain things in the right way. Am I seeing in a Did I lock the door properly? Could it be so happen that I might actually choke my baby girl to death while playing with her? Which is something which is unreasonable thoughts. But they think that like probably such things will happen. We'll directly go to case study. Okay. Now here it is. Unfortunate is thing is that in many of them, they do not approach to doctor because they do not understand that I am suffering from a generalized anxiety disorder which will impair my life along with my family members' life, you know. And because some or the other they get support in their house or family, and that's the way they get like you know accustomed. Family get accustomed and they do not take a treatment, you know, and they do not manage this, and people do not understand.
They think it is behavior only,
behavior
or it is in her genes only.
It is in genes only, or probably she is very caring, you know, she is involved, you know, people take it that way. So similar kind of a thing has happened over here in the consult, in this particular case study. ये केस स्टडी में क्या हुआ है, फातिमा नाम की एक वन लेडी वाज देयर, हाउसवाइफ 35 इयर्स ऑफ एज, हैड ऑलवेज बीन नर्वस सिंस हर चाइल्डहुड. राइट फ्रॉम द चाइल्डहुड शी वाज नर्वस. ड्यूरिंग हर स्कूल डेज शी हैड बीन एंग्शियस फॉर हर स्टडीज, शी वाज बीन एंग्शियस फॉर हर एग्जामिनेशन. शी वाज ऑल्सो एक्सट्रीमली अपसेट इफ एनी ऑफ हर फ्रेंड्स टॉक्ड इल अबाउट हर और द टीचर्स स्कोल्डेड हर. कोई और मेरे बारे में बात कर रहे हैं या फिर कोई लाइक यू नो विद दैट थॉट आल्सो शी यूज्ड टू बिकम एंग्शियस. एट होम शी बिकेम ग्रेटली वरीड इफ हर फादर केम होम लेटर देन यूजुअल. ओके, ये भी अगर कोई देर से आ रहा है तो शी यूज्ड टू गेट एंग्शियस. शी अप्रिहेंडेड सम एक्सीडेंट एंड शी वाज एडमिटेड टू कॉलेज बट शी कुड नॉट फिनिश हर ग्रेजुएशन. शी मैरिड एट द एज ऑफ 22. हर हस्बैंड हैड अ स्मॉल बिजनेस इन द टाउन. Fatima was from the very beginning apprehensive about the possible failure of her husband's business. And that's the reason she used to get worried. Now initially, husband felt probably she loves me a lot, and because of that, out of that care, like you know, she takes care of so much and she worries about me. But then he felt all the time that her for every small thing, if she is reacting and she is getting worried and she is getting nervous, then he started feeling that कुछ तो problem हो रहा है करके. Initially her husband was glad to see her worried, as he interpreted it as her attachment to him. Gradually he became irritated at the constant worry and negative predictions she had. कि हर वक्त negative prediction, इधर ये business में invest करना है, नहीं वो होगा नहीं, ये चालू करना है, नहीं वो होगा ही नहीं, उसमें ये risk है. So if somebody says and try to put objections all the time, person will obviously will get irritated.
Mr. No No. This is like Mr. No No. Every time
no. Mr. No No. This is No No.
This is No No.
He tried to convince her that every business has its own ups and downs and there is nothing to be worried about. The effort was little effect. However, he tried, but iska kuch uspe asar hi nahi hua. At the age of 26, Fatima gave birth to girl and after 4 years to boy. During pregnancy, she was extremely fearful that pregnancy would go wrong and some damage might occur to her unborn child. So, udhar bhi. Phir uske baad, as these two children, kids, like, you know, grew up, still, she used to wait in the window till her daughter used to come home. अरे उसके साथ ऐसा हुआ तो नहीं, no? Probably she would have met with accident. Unrealistic thoughts and because of that, like she used to get that, like the general anxiety disorder. General means general. हर किसी भी situation में you get anxiety baseless, no? Now coming to obsessive compulsive disorder. Okay, now this is also nowadays very common, and people are using this words. Small kids are using this OCD. Kya hai to OCD problem, you know? So in fact, because mobile addiction has also been, like, you know, used as the OCD problem. Okay, so wo bhi ho gaya, because you cannot, like, you know, prevent or avoid where you cannot see or walk, like, you know, touch mobile. So that is the feeling is nomenclatured as OCD. You know, you must be acquainted with the word obsessive and compulsive. These two terms have actually been part of everyday language nowadays. Obsession in everyday usage means being engrossed in specific thoughts. What are those thoughts? Layman usage of obsession. Look, layman kaise use karte hai? You speak of being obsessed with your looks. Some people are very obsessed with their looks. And you have seen it. Every after fourth step, you know what they are going to do it? Baal theek karenge. Shirt barabar hai ki nahi karenge. No? Ek selfie nikal ke dekhenge. So that is nothing but they are obsessed about their looks. And they'll see to that, like, you know, everything is perfect. Balo se leke, so that is obsessed with the looks. Your daughter studies, obsessed. Aisa hona nahi chahiye. Okay. Your girlfriend's whereabouts while she is away from you. Wo kahan pe hogi? Let me go and check. No? Every now and then, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, have you reached? Have you started? You also talk of being observed with a particular art form of, like, you know, you also talk about being obsessed with a particular art form, like guns, rifles. I'm very obsessed with that. People talk. I'm very obsessed with that collection of coins. I'm very obsessed with the collection of, like, you know, stamps, stickers, you know. So people are using, in a layman's language, the word obsession. Cars. Okay, fond of cars, I'm obsessed with the cars. Compulsion means, now this is what we have understood about obsession. Now coming to compulsion. Compulsion means you are forced or compelled to do something. In ordinary language, we may use it to be forced from outside, compelled by my parents, or from inside, compelled by my consciousness. Okay, so either it is compelled from outside authority or your inside consciousness. So after doing that, you will feel better. That means you are obsessed for mobile. And by touching mobile, you can compel yourself to touch mobile. And by doing that activity, what are you going to feel? You are going to feel better. So obsessive, you are compelled to touch to mobile is nothing but
OCD.
But not technically correct use of obsession and compulsion. So long you are happy and in control of these thoughts, so long these are not disturbing despite your earnest effort to ward them away, they are simply fancy words and not components of a disorder. As long as you are okay and you are able to control your thoughts, but when it becomes a disorder, disturbing thoughts, images and impulses, often of a negative or unacceptable kind, despite one's desire to get rid of it, then there is a problem. That means it is not only the thoughts, but that person is unable to control that thoughts despite of his efforts, then that becomes a disorder. As long as those are fancy words, I am obsessed, I am compelled to do, those are fancy words. So there is a thin line, either se either kab jaoge pata nahin chalega, So compulsion means being compelled from within to perform certain ritualistic act, because otherwise you are afraid of some danger befalling you. Suppose आज मैंने घर से रोज मैं घर से निकलने से पहले वो तिलक लगाता हूँ, but unfortunately आज मेरे तरफ से वो तिलक लगाना रह गया. तो that is out of the fear you do that ritual कि मेरे पे कुछ problem नहीं आना चाहिए, पर आज नहीं किया तो it becomes like
yes negative.
Yeah. According to DSM, obsessions are recurrent and persistent thoughts, impulses or images that are experienced as intrusive, that is disturbing, and generate considerably anxiety. These thoughts do not concern real life problems at the moment and are often irrelevant to present reality. The person has insight and tries to remove these thoughts but often cannot succeed. So most of the times he understands, his logic says that what am I doing it is incorrect, but he cannot control that thoughts, then it becomes a disorder. The content of the obsessive thought, wo content kya rehta hai obsessive thoughts ka? You may find unusual fear of contamination, fear of harming oneself or one's own loved ones, obsession ke wajah se, because of that thought, you may fear, I may harm someone, religious things, those are all from the obsession compulsion disorder, because there is a fear behind it. Agar main ye nahi kiya, to probably mere pe kuch na kuch problem, mere ya mere near and dear one ya family mein kuch to problem, ya main problem mein aa jaunga, main financially loss. So everything do that, rituals, all the rituals have been done out of that thought. Things of sexuality, especially the unacceptable forms, wishing ill for others, that is also a content of this OCD people. For example, wishing one's mother dead, अच्छा होगा अगर मेरी माँ मर जाए. So that kind of a thought also comes out of this OCD. Doubt about whether one has accomplished things properly, उसने वो बराबर किया तो नहीं रहेगा. You cannot delegate. OCD वाला person delegation उसको जमेगा नहीं, because he has to do everything by himself. Because I am the one who is going to do the perfectly things, so he will end up in the problem. The last line is over there. The thoughts continue to haunt her or him all the time. Compulsions are repetitive overt behaviors. Now we have seen that what is the content of the obsessive thoughts, and now we will see the compulsions are repetitive, certain obvious behavior kaise dikhta hai. compelling behavior, because after doing that compulsion, that person is going to feel better. Okay, but that is temporary feeling better, not the getting better completely. So what kind of a behavior that is going to be seen, like washing or checking, or mental acts like counting or praying in response to obsessive thoughts. बार बार जाके हाथ धोएगा, because ये गंदगी हाथ को लगती है ना. So every time I've seen many of the people after eating food, they will every now and then chips खाया, bathroom में जाके brush किया.
And even continuously one hour, two hours wash.
Then wash. Yeah, I've seen one case like that. Okay. One guest had come to our house, and before eating food, he washed his hand and he asked for a napkin. I gave, okay. And then at the time of tea time, then again he washed his hand, okay. And there were many guests, so probably he kept it somewhere, or it was close by that napkin, but still he asked another napkin. And I was thinking, why he asked the same napkin, the napkin which I have already given, he could have used that one. कि वो भी उसके दिमाग में सोच वो भी गंदा हुआ होगा ना.
Because of the texture.
Correct. But later on when I understood he's a OCD patient, and from that perspective, then you can make out कि these are certain obvious behaviors. Compulsions are to be done following rigid rules to prevent or reduce the impact of some dreaded thing or action, because they think that is a dreaded thing. And compulsion, compel activity, behavior by doing that activity, by doing everyday puja, I should not miss that puja because I want to feel better. So that becomes a compelling, and for that they feel better. After compulsion is performed, the person is temporarily feels relieved. But again, succumbs to the same cycle. So few primary kinds of a compulsion act: cleaning, repeated washing, checking, repeated coming back to home and to check if the door has been locked properly, counting the number of steps one takes before getting on the bed. Okay, so counting the numbers, they do it because their obsessive thoughts haunt their mind. And to distract them, they do such kind of activity. Repeating coming back to the first word of the line, as one is not sure if she has read it properly. कुछ पढ़ रहे हैं, पढ़ रहे हैं, पढ़ रहे हैं, तो immediately अगर उसको लगा कि मैं मेरे को समझा नहीं है, she will go back to or he will go back to the first word again, and they keep on doing again and again, repeatedly. Hoarding, collecting things and not being able to organize of these things. Many people, they want to collect many things, but they do not want to organize things. Books, I am very fancy or I am very obsessed for books. Ye kharido, wo kharido, wo. I am obsessed for shopping. Okay, but I am not organizing things. I do not know where they are lying. Then there is no, it is not getting utilized, that means. Sirf usko obsession kya hai? जाना खर लेके आना, जाना लेके आना, ये मुझे चाहिए. That's it. Ordering, arranging books on the table in a particular order each time one leaves the table. Many people have this habit also. In an excessive mode, कि जैसा table है वैसे के वैसे ही निकलते वक्त वैसा ही होगा. To some extent, from the neatness point, it is okay, but you are doing that again and again and again and again, then it is disorder. So at least by understanding such kind of action, and if some people are around us who are doing this obvious behavior, we can bring their notice instead of shouting at them, instead of blaming at them, and we can give them a right medication. At least that means we can show the door of the doctor. Obsession and compulsion as coexist. There may be cases where only obsession or compulsion predominates, but most of the time it coexists. The obsession and compulsion take plenty of time from one's daily routine and slow down the entire life process. Because of this, they spend lot of time doing things again and again, again and again, again and again, and they lose the charm of life. Say, I remember one lady, she used to go in a bathroom and to take a bath, and she used to come out of from bathroom after 2 hours. You know, she will clean his clothes first, she will clean bathroom, then she will take a bath, again she will clean bathroom, and then she will come out. And taking bath like right from the top to like, you know, the head, like probably she maybe not seen it, but probably she might be like, you know, rubbing the soap also so harshly. Many times it has been seen by doctor. That leaves the wound, yes, on the skin. Itna obsession hota hai ki nahi wo saaf nahi hua. Ragad ragad ke saabun ekdam. You know, this is also one of the symptom of OCD. So you lose your time, you spend time in doing like, you know, unwanted thing in your life. Anxiety accompanying OCD is twofold. In the first place, the obsessive thoughts are unpleasant and anxiety provoking. Compulsions reduce them to some extent, but the very insight that one is compelled to do such useless things causes a lack of confidence and severe distress or severe stress a person suffers from. So here it is, relation between obsession and compulsion. You can see it is distress due to not being able to control disturbing thoughts. Not being able to control disturbing thoughts. Disturbing thoughts of negative things, impulses or events gives the stress, and because of that further disturbing thoughts. Again, this negative stimulus, repetitive behavior, because of the negative stimulus, clean nahi hoga wo. Because of that, like repetitive stimulus, negative stimulus, repetitive behavior, wash karna haath, repetitive behavior that are believed to protect from the negative things. That person believes by washing hand, it will protect me from the infection again and again. So it is repetitive. Temporarily that person will get a relief ki chalo maine haath dhoya aur mujhe infection abhi nahi lagega. From the intrusive thoughts reinforcing the compulsion. So wo from the compulsion it comes to the feeling better. Thodi der pehle maine wo generalized anxiety disorder ka example diya, that lady, she like, you know, rushed in doctor's clinic. She had OCD also. So while narrating she was telling ki like, you know, all the time from her father's side complaint was there, you take so much time in bathroom. So understood, like it's OCD patient. Apart from that, like, you know, she was talking about cleanliness. Pura ghar mein fungus tha, wo maine saaf kiya. Pura mere bed ko fungus laga tha, wo maine, pura chadar fungus tha, wo maine bags mein rakha. So like, that is little dusty also, maybe it required to clean after 15 days or 1 month, whatever it is, but pura fungus, the terribilization.
Yeah.
Okay, and out of that, because that thoughts is haunting in her mind, fungus pe kaise sone ka, saaf karna chahiye. And she used to spend
exaggerate things.
And right from childhood, maine mere kapde kisi ko dhone ke liye nahi diya, I do it myself. And with such kind of a thoughts, you can imagine how much time she must be spending in a bathroom. She had both generalized anxiety disorder plus OCD. We'll see a case study of OCD. Raj is a 26-year-old man of considerable intelligence. He comes from an upper middle class family. He is presently employed at private firm. Okay, so this is the scenario of the patient. His difficulty started some 10 years back at the late teens when he was walking on the pavement. He accidentally stepped on something which he did not bother about at that moment. Okay. But back home, it came to his mind that it might have been a used condom. That thought came in his mind. He felt very unclean and washed himself thoroughly. He knew that he might have been wrong in his interpretation, but the thought continued to haunt him. उसको मालूम था कि शायद जो मैंने किया है चक्की है वो कंडोम नहीं था, पर फिर भी उसके दिमाग में वो आ रहा था कि ऐसा होगा, शायद हो भी सकता है, and that was haunting him. कि मैंने कितने गंदे चीज पे स्टेप किया करके. Gradually he became afraid of stepping over anything dirty on the street, with condom pieces or sputum. So most of the time while walking, he never used to walk like a normal person, but he used to search for the dirt on the pavement. So you can imagine how much time he must have, like, you know, gone, he must be wasting just for searching dirt on the pavement.
The air will be passing on. How can he stop the air?
That's the reason it is pathology, no? That's the reason it is pathology. Further, what particularly disturbed him is the vivid imagery of the person who has grubby the street. उसके बारे में भी नहीं है उसको. He started imagining कि वो आदमी कैसा होगा. Vivid imagine करने लगा. Who has done that bullshit? No? Now he takes pains to look at the road very carefully before stepping, and if ever he sees anything, he avoids that particular street for a few days if possible. Now you can imagine, if that could have been the shortest way to reach to the destiny, he would go, he will avoid that road and he will go from the long distance. It so happens that the city he leaves is not particularly clean. Then problem के उस जगह पे वैसे जगह पे वो जाएगा नहीं, रहेगा नहीं. And often there are actually dirty things on the street. If he sees anything like this, he has to wash himself following certain rituals after he reaches home. Intrusive imagery or filthy sticky things haunts him till he is back home and washes himself. He first washes. Now उसका तरीका, धोने का तरीका, खुद को wash करने का तरीका. He first washes his face 10 times. Then his arms, chest, back, legs for specific number of times. He has to take care of his feet, particularly being forced to wash them 25 times each. The washing ritual has to be completed irrespective of heat and cold, yeah, fever ho, could be ho, he will do that washing rituals. That becomes ritual for him, just like any other faith and rituals. They do it out of the OCD only, but in this case also the same. He also has to wash the surface of the soap he uses, as that too might be contaminated. अभी soap भी contaminated हो गया होगा, उसको भी पहले rub करके साफ करते हैं, and then he has to wash. Since he needs about 3 hours to wash himself, he takes dinner. He used to take up quite late. If he's eating food such a quite late, getting up also will be the problem next day. Okay? Then it will lose the productivity. Boss will shout. It's
almost 3 hours in the bathroom.
Now he is a working chap. The lady which I gave the example of general anxiety, she was like at home only. So for her it is still okay. That is a problematic for all other family members to occupy bathroom, and that also in Mumbai. Well, you can
water shortage.
So ultimately, like, you know, this is the story of OCD patient. Okay. Now coming to a somatoform disorder. Somatoform disorder. Interesting. This is also. Let us go for an embarrassing memory. Embarrassing memory. Let us remember a situation where you were humiliated in front of your classmate or colleagues for a reason which was not entirely your fault. Yes, partially due to some lapse of yours, probably something has gone wrong. You were anxious. Obviously, anybody will get anxious because you are humiliated in front of public, in front of people. But not only simply anxious, you were wishing that it had never happened. And how could you ever be so foolish to happen in front of everybody? You know, so you are not feeling only anxious, but you are blaming yourself also कि ऐसा होना ही नहीं चाहिए था करके and then what would you like to do now? What is that best thing you would like to now? ये situation तो हो गया now how to react to this? That person starts thinking have a magic and have the memory of the event wipe out from everybody's brain. Something unusual to happen at the moment so that everybody's attention is directed away from you. That is another thought. Maybe if you can put forth an excuse, maybe of a severe disease, you could not be, so that you could not feel guilty. Yeah? So suddenly aisa kuch ho jaye, aisa kuch main bol jaun, so that like you know, people will believe and think and they will not consider me as guilty. This disorder involve attempts on the part of the person to escape. What is the motto of a person? To escape the unpleasant, stressful situation by using particular intrapsychic mechanism. That person want to escape out because this is unpleasant sensation and anybody would like to escape out of it. The old anxieties are not present but are replaced by either physical symptoms or distorting the relationship between self and reality. By selective modification of memory and identity, these are respectively somatoform disorders. That means in terms of the physical symptoms, it will display, or dissociative disorders. Dissociative disorder, that means person dissociate with the self and the reality by modification between memory and identification. What is that too? We will see that. Interesting it is. Somatoform disorders and dissociative disorders.
Okay. Then illusion. These into illusion. Partly.
Dissociative disorder, yes, partly you can, that person wanders away
from the reality.
So we'll see, when we'll see the case study, we'll come to know. Very interesting that is also, because however, you know, people diagnose anxiety, but what type of anxiety? That is also person has to identify. And that is the crucial thing from the psychiatric department also to diagnose. What is he suffering from? Because otherwise all the symptoms are like, you know, looks and sounds and see the like, you know, behavior more or less it's same. But usme kaun sa hai anxiety wala? You know, type. So that once the diagnosis is proper, then probably they can treat well and they can give psychotherapy well. Because treating patient goes hand in hand from the psychiatric medication as well as psychotherapy medication. If unable to find the phobia hai, to psychotherapy kaise denge? Agar psychotherapy work nahi denge properly, to ye medication bhi utna use nahi honga. Ultimately, goal of any psychiatrist is to reduce the dose, titrate the dose. You cannot keep the patient on like, you know, increasing dose, because all the psychiatric medication has side effects. And he wants to curb the dosage as early as possible or reduce the, like, you know, molecules. Because if you see, koi bhi prescription kholke dikha, to char paanch to molecules milenge hi milenge, brands milenge hi milenge. So from that point of view, diagnosis is very important and challenging for a doctor's point of view. Somatoform disorders symptoms are when you have been under considerable stress. You may have experienced bodily symptoms like headache or gastric problem. Suddenly you will start feeling in a stressful situation ki mujhe yahan ache ho raha hai, yahan gastric problems aa rahe hai. Okay, this psychological pain seems to take a physical or somatic form. This is not a actual physical pain, but that takes a psychological form of a pain where a person feels ki I am getting aches, and it aches at मल्टीपल लोकेशंस, एक ही जगह पे नहीं, एक ही जगह पे लोकेशन है तो यू कैन ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई द कॉज. शायद बहुत देर तक ऐसे बैठ के बैठे थे लेक्चर के लिए, सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू आर गेटिंग अ नेक पेन. जस्टिफाइबल, यहाँ भी हो रहा है, यहाँ भी हो रहा है, ओके, मुझे जॉब में भी हो रहा है, मुझे यहाँ पे भी हो रहा है, यहाँ पे भी हो रहा है, मल्टीपल है, यू कैन कम टू द कंक्लूजन. दिस इज क्वाइट कॉमन इन चिल्ड्रन एंड नॉट सो कॉमन अमंग एडल्ट्स. Teachers in junior schools are well aware of how frequently children develop symptoms like stomachache and nausea in response to academic or interpersonal stress. Kal exam hai, kal test hai, so suddenly ya subah subah I am not prepared for the maths. Then like you know, child is going to say stomach upset hai, I am feeling dizzy, I am getting fever, I am feeling weak, don't send me to the school. So that is, that comes out of somatotype form of disorder. So somatoform disorder, not disorders, you can say these are symptoms. Disorders are different. Okay, जैसे हम लोग ने normal anxiety देखा and pathological anxiety देखा. Okay, similarly, again you may have seen or heard stories of people fainting whenever they encounter any stress. So the example which I gave of my colleague, when she saw a camera, immediately she exposed and panic and fainted and collapsed. So that is also, it will come under body. इसको कुछ problem था क्या अंदर? नहीं था, but still she fainted and collapsed. And after some time she was okay. Sometimes they may be simply faking the symptoms to draw attention or to avoid immediate embarrassment. But many times they truly experience the bodily pain or truly lose consciousness. सच में ही वो consciousness lose करते हैं, but sometimes fake भी हो सकता है. This may be example of somatoform disorders. Somatoform disorders refer to a group of disorders where the person reports physical complaints characteristic of bodily dysfunction, but investigation usually fails to elicit any actual physical defect. मतलब body में कुछ problem नहीं है उसको, but still is showing the physical dysfunction कहीं ना कहीं पे हुआ है या हो रहा है. That's what he/she claims. Now, different types of somatoform disorders. Somatization disorder, pain disorder, hypochondriasis, conversion disorder, body dysmorphic disorder. So quickly we'll go through them. Somatization disorder, you may recognize somatization disorder by the presence of multiple physical symptoms at different location of the body. Okay, there must be at least 4 pain symptoms in different sides of body, head, neck, back, etc. मतलब एक वक्त पे at least 4 points पे तो भी pain दिखना चाहिए. Okay, now this is more important. Mandates that it must begin before 30 years of age. 30 years के बाद नहीं. 30 years के बाद that could be because of the old age. बॉडी पेन्स तो ओल्ड एज की वजह से शुरू होता है, जॉइंट पेन से शुरू होता है. 30 साल के अंदर किसी को इस तरह के प्रॉब्लम नहीं होने चाहिए बॉडी एज. एटलीस्ट 2 गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टिनल सिम्टम्स, डायरिया होना चाहिए या नॉजिया होना चाहिए, 2 कुछ तो GI प्रॉब्लम्स होनी चाहिए. 1 सेक्शुअल सिम्टम्स अदर देन पेन, इरेक्टाइल डिसफंक्शन, द लैक ऑफ डिजायर. 1 स्यूडो न्यूरोलॉजिकल सिम्टम, फेंटिंग. अगर इतना सब, अगर if you identify in any of the person, then you can say that like you know it's suffering from somatization. Adequate medical investigation must have been made to exclude all known organic origin of the symptoms. So before you could say he is not like you know, you need to do adequate investigation. Isme real mein pain ke problems ya causes hai, causative reasons hai, neurological damage hai kahin pe, या GI में कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, अल्सर है, वो क्लियर करने के बाद और सब रिपोर्ट नॉर्मल आने के बाद फिर भी ये कंप्लेंट आ रहा है, देन इट इज अ डिसऑर्डर.
बट पेशेंट सिजोफ्रेन पेशेंट्स आल्सो आर हाइडिंग दिस रियलिटीज एंड ऑल. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ दिस पेशेंट कम्स इन दिस मेडिक
सिजोफ्रेनिक पेशेंट्स, दैट इज ऑल टुगेदर अ डिफरेंट थिंग. ओके, schizophrenic patient feels that like you know somebody is following me, you know I can sense somebody. Okay, he talks to me. Okay, I talk to him. I'm scared of him. He's going to harm me. Okay, some sound he feels all the time, and he speaks irrelevant. If you talk, so these are all, that is different. Okay, so when we move further. In dissociate identity, know, many times, you know, doctor may get confused between those. And many of the times, like, you know, they diagnose as a schizophrenic rather than dissociative.
Because they are hiding the real identity though.
But yeah. these problems are more common than the
schizophrenia. Yes, these are all anxiety. Anxiety is very common. So we can. Okay, so the symptoms of somatization disorder are vague. Okay, the person often goes for doctor shopping and frequent hospitalization. Okay. Sometimes as a result of unwarranted faulty treatment and invasive interventions, actual physical symptoms may occur to complicate the issue. Depression and anxiety may accompany the somatization symptoms. Okay, we'll go to case study so that we'll come to know clearly what is it means exactly. Rina is a 24-year-old middle class married woman. She had lost her mother in her childhood and has been reared up by her father. Before her marriage, she suffered from migraine and frequent cold. After marriage, she had encountered difficulty at her in-law's house. Her mother-in-law expected her to take some household responsibility, which she could not complete due to her frequent headache. She disliked her mother-in-law and wished her dead. Okay. Her husband was initially supportive of her, but gradually became irritated due to her constant complaints. Rina became depressed and developed pain in her neck, back, which prevent her from sitting straight for long. Her headache has become more frequent and severe. She also has a frequent sore throat. She developed problem of digestion and often had a diarrhea and nausea. Her hands trembles at the slightest provocation and she had fainted a few times after quarreling with her husband. Her sexual desire is on the decline and she complains of pain during intercourse. Her husband is very dissatisfied with the state of affairs and is contemplating to give divorce. Okay, so this is what her case study as far as the somatization is concerned. That means person gets keep on complaining, whether it is are those complaints or not, but that person keeps complaining. Now coming to pain disorder, you may find that some people experience persistent pain in certain specific areas of the body. No physical cause can usually be identified through investigation. Even if some organic problem is observed, it is inadequate to explain the state's subjective degree of pain. The psychological factors are recognized as significant precipitator of the pain significantly or symptom. That means all are psychosomatic. Okay, means nothing is physical cause or it is related with that. Pain disorder. Now, Joseph is a 17-year-old manual laborer from a tribal area working in the city. Okay, so he is the oldest in three siblings. He was very good at his study. He wanted to study very well. But unfortunately, his father lost his job because of alcohol consumption. And then mother forced him. Ki tu beta ek kaam kar, abhi tu padhai chhod de aur like you know, baap ki jagah pe lag ja. He was annoyed. He was not reluctant. He was not ready to do that because he used to love study. Because of the teacher used to love him. So because of that, he wanted to study. तो इसमें हुआ ऐसा कि लाइक नाउ अनफॉर्चुनेटली फोर्सफुली ही हैड टू जॉइन द जॉब बट द जॉब वाज नॉट लाइक यू नो ही नेवर यूज्ड टू लाइक दैट काइंड ऑफ अ जॉब ओके व्हाट ही वाज डूइंग सो एक बार ऐसा हो गया कि वो ऊपर से गिर गया है लाइक यू नो ही हैड फ्रैक्चर इन एंकल सो देन आफ्टर सम टाइम लाइक यू नो आफ्टर सम पीरियड ऑफ टाइम इट गॉट क्लियर पर नाउ अभी इसका प्रॉब्लम क्या हो गया कि डिस्पाइट ऑफ नाउ मींस एवरीथिंग इज ऑल राइट Still, he complains of pain, and that plain pain triggers a lot before going to job. Early in the morning, that pain triggers a lot. Now, that is again psychosomatic problem with him. नहीं है, फिर भी वो बोल रहे कि है, and now with the help of somebody's help, he gets up. That has been over. That pain has overpowered so much. that there is actual no damage to the bone or the muscle and all. But for getting up also, this man now takes help home for other person. Now he is sitting at home and not doing nothing. He has come under that psychosomatic problem. Now coming to hypochondriasis. Interesting this is also. Hypochondriasis is characterized by fear of physical disease. These people have a fear of physical disease, and those physical disease also chota mota physical disease nahi, like life threatening diseases. You name it as cardiac attack, you name it as cancer. They think chota flu bhi ho gaya, cold and ye ho gaya, then also they will think like I'm suffering from like you know some big disease, you know that kind of thing. You may have come across person who suspect that they have a serious diseases like cancer and cardiac problems. Investigations, however, reveal that no organic pathology is present. While many of us may occasionally read some bodily discomfort as a sign of some serious problem, the person with hypochondriasis is quite convinced about the presence of the disease. यहाँ पे differ होता है. We also suspect because of the over knowledge and because of the internet. We also try to link the like you know symptoms.
People go see the yes. side effect. अरे मेरे को भी वही हो गया.
Okay. Even normal people do it, but here difference of hypochondriasis उनका पूरा conviction level ही है कि मुझे यही हुआ है. आप उनको X-ray निकाल के दिखाओ. आप उनको blood test का report निकाल के दिखाओ. डॉक्टर ने लिख के एंडोर्स स्टैम्प करके पांच डॉक्टर ने लिख के स्टैम्प करके एंडोर्स किया दैट डायग्नोसिस इज रॉन्ग एंड फुली कन्विंस्ड और मुझे यही हुआ है दे गो टू दैट लेवल एंड दे डू अ डॉक्टर शॉपिंग एंड दे टेक अ ट्रीटमेंट्स यू नो कीप ऑन टेकिंग द ट्रीटमेंट्स इतने का नहीं मुझे यही हुआ है करके दे विल गो एंड कंप्लेन ऑल्सो टू द डॉक्टर सो दैट इज द So as per DSM classification states that preoccupation with the fear of contracting or having a serious disease is the main criteria of hypochondriasis. The conviction is based on the misinterpretation of some transitory bodily symptoms. For example, a person may interpret a sore throat as a sign of cancer. Sore throat cancer. No? यहाँ तक. अभी मैं when I was in Sion Hospital, I saw one patient. Okay, the OPD is going on. So many patients are there in the OPD time and rush time. So doctor, it's not like you know close, not clean. Clinics are not so close. I mean not closed clinics. They are open OPD. हाँ दरवाजा खुला रहता है. Doctor यहाँ पे patient देखता रहता है. And that lady was standing outside. And doctor was busy with like you know with the first patient. And that lady suddenly she got up. 25-26 year old she was. Okay. Suddenly she got up. Doctor, sir phat rahe hai, sir phat rahe hai. Doctor said, okay, मैं देखता हूँ, मेरा patient खत्म होने दो, मैं देखता हूँ करके. Okay. Then जो भी साथ में relative आया था, उसको बोलो कि उसको बिठा के लेके बिठाओ. After a few seconds again, doctor, मेरा सर फट रहे हैं. कुछ करो, देखो अभी. You know, अभी खत्म हो गया, अभी फट रहे हैं. वापस बैठो वापस ही वॉट अप एंड नहीं डॉक्टर सब हिल रहे हैं कुछ करो डॉक्टर हिल रहे हैं वापस मैं गिर जाऊंगी अभी डॉक्टर मुझे हार्ट अटैक आ रहा है यहाँ तक आ रहे हैं देखता हूँ बैठो वहाँ पे तो यू कैन इमेजिन कुछ भी अगर महसूस भी होता है हार्ट बीट भी बढ़ रहा है तब भी दे विल थिंक दैट दैट इज हार्ट अटैक सो फियर ऑफ फियर यू कैन से कुछ हुआ नहीं होता है उनको एक्चुअली बट दे हैव दैट लाइक यू नो फियर दैट आई एम सफरिंग फ्रॉम बिग डिजीज और डिसऑर्डर सो दिस इज नथिंग बट हाइपोकॉन्ड्रियासिस directly taking coming to a case study okay Dinesh is 35 year old over here, upper middle class, educated, employed man from a metropolitan city. He had an affair with a girl who later turned out to be a sophisticated prostitute. So Dinesh learned it the hard way and was both heartbroken and horrified. That was about 6 years back. He was afraid that he might have contracted HIV, and after much deliberation, consulted a doctor who recommended blood test karwa ke dekh lo bhai, tumhara doubt clear karo. Dinesh turned out to be a negative to his immediate relief. Immediate relief ho gaya, chalo main negative ho gaya. However, this assurance seemed to be a short leap. थोड़े काल समय तक उसको लगा कि ओके फाइन आई गॉट अ रिलीफ. As he never came to believe permanently that he was not affected with HIV. After the first testing, he had about to severe cold, which he attributed to the same undetected virus HOKA, जो कि मुझे because of that मेरा immune system down है and because of that I am suffering from cold. ना सो वो लिंक वहाँ पे उसने कर दिया. He had read plenty of information on HIV AIDS and had learned that positive finding on the blood test ensures that you have HIV, but a negative finding may be misleading also. ऐसे भी है, तो वो भी उसने पकड़ के दिमाग में रखा कि ऐसा भी हो सकता है. He went for retesting and was again found negative. Okay. Now he interprets every little stomach upset, feverish feeling as indicative of HIV. He spends the whole evening scrutinizing his body, looking for swollen glands and skin rashes, because he has seen कि उसका क्या क्या symptoms होता है. तो हर कुछ चीज वो observe कर रहा है या scrutinize कर रहा है. He goes to doctors for every small ailment through, though he does not always reveal his suspicious about HIV, he insists on being treated with strong antibiotics as he believes that he has a low immunity. Okay? तो वो doctor को बताता रहता है कि आप मेरे को like you know higher antibiotics दे दो, छोटा छोटा चीज से मेरा जाने वाला नहीं है कभी. He rejects those doctors who prefer to treat with lesser medication. ज्यादा बड़ा medicine जो लिख रहा है वो अच्छा डॉक्टर है, कुछ नहीं हुआ है, natural naturopathy ले लो, is not a good doctor. So he doesn't prefer that. Convulsion disorder, the most common symptom was fainting or paralysis of the limbs under psychosocial process. We'll come to dissociative disorder. Okay, dissociative disorder. You must have seen films and read stories where after psychological shock, the hero seemed to have lost his memory. Okay, मेरा नाम क्या है? मैं कहाँ हूँ? Okay, ऐसे बहुत सारे movies आ गए. He cannot recognize people, nor can he remember his own identity.
Dementia.
Then suddenly after a chain of events that make up the story, his memory returns and everything ends happily. Such stories reflect often in an exaggerated and oversimplified fashion the essence of dissociative disorder. Okay, dissociative disorder हम लोग ने बोला कि dissociate with the real and self. Okay, three major dissociative disorders: dissociative amnesia and fugue, depersonalization disorder and dissociative identity disorder. Okay, so let us see one by one. Dissociative amnesia. Amnesia means inability to remember something to relate with a memory. Amnesia many appear as a psychological escape from stress. Stress में याद नहीं रहता है कि like अभी क्या हुआ था, अभी क्या खा किया है या कुछ. So like if you get trapped in the stressful situation, it affects the memory. But it may be a symptom in many organic diseases also. Dissociative amnesia has been defined by DSM as a disturbance in one or more episodes of life or inability to recall significant events. जो significant important events है वो भी क्या हो गया, wipe out हो गया. Okay, so lifetime में ऐसा दो या तीन बार अगर हो गया हो तो dissociative amnesia आपको है. That's what it is. This manual talks about. In this regard, neurological investigation is very important. Okay, it would give you first lead, but there are other functional differences as well. तो एक तो आपको पहले इन्वेस्टिगेट करना है कि एक डिसोसिएटिव एमनेशिया है कि न्यूरोनल डैमेज है। अगर न्यूरोनल डैमेज है, कुछ पार्ट का ब्रेन को कुछ अगर डैमेज हुआ है, तो प्रोबेबली यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू रिमेम्बर थिंग्स, ओके, शॉर्ट टर्म मेमोरी, लॉन्ग टर्म मेमोरी, परमानेंट, सो विच एवर पार्ट हैज व्हाट डिसफंक्शन, तो उस बेसिस पे यू कैन से कि ये न्यूरोनल प्रॉब्लम है। बट इन केस ऑफ दिस यू हैव टू फर्स्ट रूल आउट पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ न्यूरोलॉजिकल डैमेज, कि वो करने के बाद देन यू कैन पुट लाइक यू नो यू आर सफरिंग फ्रॉम एमनेशिया, डिसोसिएटिव एमनेशिया। This usually happens following some stressful condition. The information is not permanently lost. ये इसका differentiation है. This can be retrieved by hypnosis, narcotic analysis or sometime spontaneously भी वो आ जाता है. तो completely ये loss नहीं हुआ है permanently. Dissociative amnesia can be localized for specific period of life. Specific period localized इतना इतना याद नहीं आ रहा है, पर बाकी सब याद है. अभी अभी का वो याद नहीं रख रही है, पर पिछले का पूरा याद रख रही है, ओके, स्पेसिफिक। और मे बी जनरलाइज्ड ओवर मेजर पार्ट ऑफ अ पर्सन्स लाइफ, पूरा जो मेजर पार्ट है जनरल पे कुछ पूरी तरह से भूल गई है, नाउ दैट कुड बी पॉसिबल। इट कैन बी सिलेक्टेड दैट इज स्पेसिफिक इवेंट्स मे बी लॉस, इट कैन बी कंटिन्यूस ऑल्सो एंड दैट इज नथिंग इज रिमेंबर्ड बियॉन्ड अ सर्टेन पॉइंट। लोकलाइज एंड सिलेक्टिव एमनेशिया आर मोर कॉमन, लोकलाइज एंड सिलेक्टिव। Dissociative fugue. The word fugue means flight. Okay. Dissociative fugue is sudden, unexpected traveling away from home or work. Suddenly वो बाहर निकल जाता है. That is dissociative fugue. This is often accompanied with amnesia, loss of memory. कि क्यों किया है मैंने? मैं क्यों बाहर भटकता हूँ? Okay. You may find the person with a fugue confused about personal identity and she may also assume a new identity. She may assume ये मेरी नई identity है. Once she has or he has out of the home or work and get a new identity and does something else. What she was doing it, what was her qualification, wiped off. Okay. Acquired new identity.
Same as split for the person.
Split personality, that is multiple personality, that is bit different. That is bit different. That way we'll cover. If you look into her case history, you may discover that fugue occurred after a stressful event, which probably was difficult to handle staying in the same place. That person difficult to handle staying in that place and goes out somewhere to get rid of that situation. You know that even Alzheimer dementia, which is an organic disease, people tend to wander away. Usme bhi, but that is a memory loss over there. But here it is not permanent memory loss. Okay, that is a degenerative disorder. The motive to flight along with the absence of other symptoms, dementia distinguishes dissociative fugue from wandering the Alzheimer disease. Coming to a case study, so we'll come to know properly what it is. Bobby, 35, was a middle manager at the sales department of private firm. For the last few months, he was being consistently unable to reach the target and was receiving unpleasant feedback from the boss and the subordinates. At home also, he was having marital problems. One day, he did not come back home from work. His wife waited for him till midnight and then informed the police. After about 7 days, he was found wandering in small town far off from the city. He was having an argument with the local people near a tea shop where he had stopped for a cup of tea. He had identified himself as a Navin. His name was not Navin, but he was telling that I am Navin and affirmed that he was looking for a job. However, he could not produce any identification or could not say anything about his past. The local people had been suspicious, held him back and informed the police. When the police found Navin, like you know, that is Bobby, he could not remember his identity or how he had reached this place. He was wearing the same dress he had in 7 days. However, his orientation to the time and the date was intact. Okay. So, in this case, loss is not permanent, memory loss is not permanent. It can, with the proper techniques, he can bring his memory back. okay, hypnosis ho gaya, treatment ho gaya, we can do. It is not permanent loss. But during that time period, that person leaves or like, you know, could not remember who. So he acquired identity, like, because otherwise is normal. But he is unable to recall what he was and what he is. Now coming to a depersonalization disorder. Depersonalization means what? Sometimes under pressure, you may have felt somewhat detached from reality. As if what is happening is not true. Something is happening, but that is not detached from the detached from the reality. It is not happening. Or as if you are observing the sequence of events as an outsider. This is not me which is happening with me. Observing the situation as a external person. You know, so that way it is depersonalized. Detaching from
trying to run away from
them. Yeah. Yeah. Here also is a run away from them because stress is unpleasant. Want to run away. Okay, so here it is memory modification. There it is displaying the physical symptoms in case of somatoform. But here it is not displacement. Here it is detaching. कैसे भी करके स्ट्रेस से बाहर निकलने का डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म है बॉडी का. सो दिस इज वन मोड ऑफ टॉलरेटिंग. ओके, दिस इज वन मोड ऑफ टॉलरेटिंग इमेंस पेन. बाय डूइंग दैट ब्रेन इज प्रोटेक्टिंग योर सेल्फ. दिस इज वन वे टू टॉलरेट इमेंस पेन यूज्ड ऑटोमेटिकली बाय द ह्यूमन माइंड. डीपर्सनलाइजेशन मीन्स फीलिंग एज इफ वन इज नॉट वन सेल्फ. मैं वो हूँ ही नहीं तो पेन मुझे फील होगा ही नहीं. जो भी सिचुएशन स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन, आई एम नॉट देयर, आई एम नॉट फीलिंग माई सेल्फ, सो देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम ऑफ पेन. बिकॉज ऑल पेन्स मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम वी आर सीइंग इट व्हेन इट इज स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन, साइकोसोमेटिक पेन्स. डी रियलाइजेशन मीन्स दैट इफ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग अराउंड इज नॉट रियल. व्हाइल दिस मे हैपन टू एनीबॉडी अंडर एक्सट्रीम कंडीशन, ए पर्सन परसिस्टेंटली एंड रिकरेंटली suffers from this kind of experiences, you may think of diagnosing her as suffering from depersonalization disorder, experiencing repeatedly. I have seen one case in Saran Hospital, that lady, she had come with a problem in year 2002, that time she was pregnant and pregnancy was of 4 months and that time she started feeling the baby is not mine. She started getting that kind of a feeling. So she started rejecting and she was getting that feeling ki ye bachcha mera nahi hai. So that is depersonalization disorder. So she approached doctor, she took a treatment, okay, she delivered baby normal. After 4 years in year 2007 again she started getting ki ye daughter is not mine. Again in 2012 she started getting the same feeling. Now it is 2016, I recently seen. So repeatedly that cycle comes after certain period. But this is all part of anxiety. Okay. So it is, but here it is depersonalized disorder where person is not
is
thinking.
Is it that is because of some other stress affected?
There could be, but the origin was, before this could happen, she used to be in a stressful situation. Some triggering event was there and because of that, because see for everything, there has to have some stressful situation. Isne mujhe bola, isne mujhe mara, and then your own brain is in, not in a position to cope up with that thing. And there are could be a genetic origin, there could be a biochemical changes immediately, and then your learning approach comes, and then what interpretation you give, that approach comes. And then because of that again
hormonal changes occur because of some things.
Yes. Biochemical changes means hormonal changes. Biochemical changes, you can call that as a neurotransmitters also. Because there is a nervous system and some neurons messages goes to the brain. Stronger the messages, stronger those feelings. Ultimately a objective of brain is to protect yourself. तो उस तरह से अपना कुछ ना कुछ तो हार्मोन्स आते ही रहते रहते. देयर आर सेरोटोनिन लेवल कम हो रहा है, यू फील डिप्रेस्ड, यू नो. सो केमिकल्स का केमिकल लोचा तो मुन्ना भाई ने बोला ही है, उसका तो इस पे हाथ है ही है.
This is again going into philosophy. He recognizes what is happening around us. It is going under the philosophy, and this is like a maya of the.
Correct, that is the spiritual angle. Well, everybody don't understand that. Then again they come into the problem. And because of that, psychiatric medicine is like, you know, growing like anything.
वो भी सब जगह साइकोलॉजी ट्रीटमेंट जो दे रहे हैं वो भी पाया है.
So we are through with the deep. I'm not taking through the case study. The case study which I have shared with you, that is sufficient, like, you know, to understand the personalized disorder. Dissociative identity disorder. This is something which is this will take last, and then we will end. Maybe depression we will take it next time. Okay. So here we are completing all the types of, like, you know, anxiety. Okay. Dissociative identity disorder. The most well-known example of dissociative identity disorder is the story of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. So these are the people who were suffering from dissociative disorder. Now imagine, one was like into the kind and generous role, and one was other a killer. You know? So how would you feel if you go to sleep in your night suit at night and wake up in the morning to find yourself in completely different attire? And your shoes clad with mud. You do not know what you did at night. If it happens for days, maybe you are having a different personality at night. So this is dissociative identity. दिन में एक रहेगा, रात में आप दूसरे रहोगे. पर आपको मालूम भी नहीं रहेगा रात में मैंने क्या किया. But you will get surprised. अरे मेरे जूते कैसे खराब हो गए. No? So it is two dual personality is made. So DSM, you must ensure, as per DSM, you must ensure that she has at least two separate ego states known as alters, and they would be in complete control of your thinking, feeling and acting for different periods of time. Now these people, this also known as multiple personality disorder earlier, but now it is dissociative identity disorder. Now it has changed. Earlier it was multiple personality disorder. यहाँ पे दो personality absolutely day or night में, like, they behave separately. Their thinking is different. Their behavior is different. You know, one would be like calm and other would be aggressive. You know, that way it is. And whichever will be, like, you know, the
dominant,
that will be, like, you know, your second part personality. Sometimes these alters are in touch with each other. Often at least one alter is unaware of the existence of another. Therefore, gaps in memory are common signs. The existence of the different alters is persistent and recurrent and not introduced by any chemical substance. Okay. These alters may have different or even opposite nature. They may dress, eat, interact differently during that time period. Often the subordinate alter works at covert level while the host or the original personality is operating at the surface level. मतलब जो weak है, जो host है, जो real है, वो obvious सबके सामने है, but जो something which is hidden or secret, you know, that will act as a second personality. In such cases, the subordinate alter is said to be a co-conscious. Gradually, this alter makes its presence felt and at one point takes over the control from the host. Okay. So, case study we'll see and then we'll stop over here. Munna was a young boy in his teens, known to be an obedient, if not very good student at school. Was obedient. He came from middle class family and lived with his parents in a city. He was shy by nature and introvert, though good at games. That was his overall nature. At one point of time, his parents started observing that Munna was becoming frigidity and suppressive and unable to explain some of his time away from home. There were reports from the schools that he was being absent While Munna could not remember anything, ki main gaya kahan tha. His parents suspected that Munna might be involved in addiction and brought him to a psychiatrist. While being asked by the doctor about his activities, Munna suddenly spoke in a different tone and identified himself as a Muni, a rough and tough fellow with an aggressive personality and lack of concern for social rules. Munip said that he knows all about Munna, the boy who is innocent. He bunked school and went to bad boys to learn their ways to fight outer world. Now Munip knows everything about Munna, but Munna doesn't know everything about Munip. So within that, one person knows about the other alter, but not both. Somewhere they are connected because he knows about him. Now what he knows about him? Munim also said that he had appeared to save Munna from his troubles. Later on, Munna revealed that as a small child, he had witnessed gross physical and sexual torture of his mother by his father and grandparents. So somewhere he has witnessed that, he has seen that, like he's been beaten. My mother has been beaten, but because of a small child, he could not do anything about that. So he must have felt a weak over there. And that's the reason, after some years, probably that aggressive Munim came out of him. You know, he was so afraid that he never let his parents know what he had seen. Upon ask, the parents admitted the truth of family violence, which was doubly related and particularly emotional while Munna's grandparents were alive. Munna's parents patched up the relation after the older generation passed away and Munna grew up. Munip seemed to compensate for the suppressed aggression Munna had against his father's son. Okay. So we will stop over here. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I have one question. So, see, where were we?